Pitstop! Hey, this is the part where I get to talk to you about little more than Power BI, because I don't think it's really about the tool. It's about what you do with the tool. In fact, it's about what we do with our lives. And that's why I want to talk about something which I think we all struggle with, which is overwhelm. I mean, gosh, yeah, that's our modern lives, right? They're never enough hours in the day. Now, I want to share a story which helped me. So this was about at the beginning of 2016, and there was a lot going on in Power BI at that time. Just to me, it felt like it had just kind of exploded, and I felt like I needed to stay on top of it all, because I was the teacher, right? I was a trainer, the Power BI Pro. I needed to know it all, and I was failing miserably. And I was so lucky that I ran into somebody who's far wiser than me, Bill Jelen. He's known as Mr. Excel. And I was talking to him about something else, nothing to do with overwhelm, none of that discussion, just off about something else. And he said, "Avi, I don't know Excel." And I did a double take. I'm like, what's he talking about? He's Mr. Excel. But after that dramatic pause, he finished his sentence. He said, "I don't know all of it." Now, he said it kind of casually, but he didn't realize the impact it had on me, because from that, I gave myself permission to not know Power BI. I'm like, hey, if it's okay for Mr. Excel, who's written, I don't know, a gazillion books on Excel, to not know all of Excel, I think it's okay for me to not know all of Power BI. So since then, I've really tried to focus on kind of the 80-20 rule. I do believe in that. I think it's the 20% of you know, the core concepts that are going to give you the 80% of the results. But if you look out, if you look at the blogs and, oh my God, Twitter or, well, YouTube channels are great, actually. So YouTube channels are great. But everything else, it's so much noise, and it's all a lot of shiny things. And yeah, you get the monthly updates and so forth. But hey, here's a secret, my friend. You know that 20%, that core concepts that you need to focus on? They don't change month to month. Yeah, they're pretty static. In fact, they have been for quite a while. And yeah, they change very gradually. So if you focus on that and you master that, there's less of that overwhelm. You can kind of, you know, push that away for a little bit while you focus on the concepts. And guess what? Once you have mastered those concepts, everything else becomes easy. And at that point, you don't have to kind of go and actively learn. In fact, Google is your friend. Whatever you're trying to do after you've mastered the core concepts, just Google it, and you would be able to not only understand the solution that you find, you would also have the skills to kind of adapt it. You'll go, oh yeah, I know how that's working, and you know, I can kind of adopt it. So I really hope that that helps you create maybe a safe space for learning. So when you come to watch the next video or the following ones, I want you to just, you know, hang up your FOMO hat, the fear of missing out, right? I mean, always like checking our phones and all that stuff. Just hang that up and just focus on one thing at a time and welcome yourself to the land of JOMO, joy of missing out. There is indeed a lot of joy in missing out. So hey, all of that I said, I hope it helps, but it's certainly not from the point of, oh yeah, I've mastered this thing and yeah, you should listen to me. I struggle with this day to day, every day. I just wanted to share some things which helps me get back my balance. And I would love to hear from you. Who are your favorite, I don't know, author quotes, tricks, whatever, which helps you fight overwhelm and get to the land of JOMO. So let me know in the comment down below. I would love to hear from you. Power on, my friends.